guys, and welcome here to the Straight Talk series. Race number 20 here today from, just before I tell you where we are, I bet you're all scratching your heads at home like, wait a second, this was supposed to be Road America, wasn't it? Yes, it was. Unfortunately, for those who have Facebook, you guys already know by now. I posted an update about this. For those who don't have Facebook or have not liked our page, you should, because that's where all the updates go. So be sure to like it. But yeah, so many of you, that's what I was saying, most of you saying probably right now, this is supposed to be Road America, isn't it? It's not. Unfortunately, I couldn't get Road America to work. And I tinkered with it so many times, and I gave up. I lost patience. So I said, I'll just pick out another road course. So today, I'm proud to say, race number 20 here from Canadian Tire Motorsports Park. And I'm Brian James up here in the booth today. Starting on the pole, Ace Rogers. And in second will be Gabriel Wanderley. I mentioned race number 20. Once again, I'm going to repeat it. Race 20. That means after today, 6 races remain till we get to the chase. Someone, like I said, we have a lot of first-time winners this season. We have 17 different winners this season. Only 12 spots available in the chase. Someone is going to have to get through this dog pile that is the one-win column. Someone's going to have to break through today. Could that be Ace Rogers? Gabriel Wanderley, they both have a win this season. But it's a dog pile. Something's going to have to give there for these guys to make the chase. Who's going to do it? We're going to find out in a second. Here is your starting line here from Canadian Tire in Canada. Pace car will peel off. They will make their way to the final corner. McCree flag will fly. We are underway. Does not want to give up. Ace Rogers doing everything he can to get ahead of him. Gabriel Wanderley says, though, he's going to put up a fight. There's only 11 left. Ooh, they almost touched there. And this is where Rogers is going to get him. Ace Rogers will clear for the lead as you see them go through that corner. This is our second road course of the season, our second to last as well. We have one more coming up in the chase at Watson Glen. That should provide for an exciting race. Next race we head to Darlington. Then we will head to Kansas, Nashville, Richmond. Richmond. Auto Club, and then Chicagoland. Sorry, I had a complete brain fart right there. So those are the final 4 races before the chase. Darlington's going to be a tricky one. I'll tell you, Darlington's going to be tricky. Kansas and Nashville shouldn't be half bad. Same for Richmond and Fontana. These guys, for the most part, have gotten through the rough part of the schedule. And then we head to Chicagoland after that. That could be an exciting race right there. Yeah, Road America being off the schedule. That kind of, I don't know, a lot of these guys were told in an email by Race Control saying, do not bring the cars to Road America, we've had an issue. Actually, it was my fault, so I don't know why it's not playing on my computer. I tried both computers. Keep in mind, I have two computers, the one that I use for years, and then this is my brand new one. Neither of them work for some reason. So, I apologize for that. If any of you guys know how to fix it, let me know. I mean, I've played with the shared track folder and stuff, and it just didn't work. Anyways, we'll be running the Cup race here at Canadian Tire as well, so just want to let you guys know that. We'll be running the Cup here, and then, like I said, if we can get it fixed for next season, we will run Road America next season. If not, I may just hold a poll on what road course to run. Pete Rogers had a terrible run through that corner, and Corbin Flaherty and Gabriel Longley both are going to take advantage of it. If we head up the hill, we'll enter, I believe, the final quarters here. We're entering a carousel, sort of. Gabriel Wanderley finally has the advantage. He will take the lead away. Or will he? He should be able to. Coming out of the corner, side draft, but Gabriel Wanderley is your leader that lap. And he'll take it away. Alba Wanderley is locked in the chase. Gabriel, not quite. He has one win. If he can get his second here today, he would be locked into the chase. So a lot of implications here for this team. And Ace Rogers is all over him, though. Honestly, though, this top 7 or 8, they are just inseparable right now. DJ Curtis got a nose on the 97, and he's going to be able to make a run going up the hill. And now Ace Rogers will try to make his run again. He's going to try and tell that 16, I'm not going down without a fight. Ace Rogers knows he needs a good run today to stay in the chase contention. This would be considered a good run for them. But at the same time, they want to win. And the quarter, Wanderley is still lead. And there goes the 28. Have a win this year. This would be a second. DJ Curtis. Here he goes. Happen if they come to the pit lane. That'll get the 26th to lead. Yeah. take a look at the guy if he stayed out. Now they will come to the pit lane. They've built four tires out in the way. Hang on, believe. Bruce Rogers will fall the third. Marcus Wish is the second win with clinch, the chase spot based on win. Like I mentioned in Countdown 3, it's a dog pile right now. Too many one-win drivers. One of them, a ton of them, all of them are capable of being on the chase. Some of them can get two wins. There's no way all of them get two wins with six races to go after today. Oh boy! DJ Curtis was not going to be denied. He takes the lead away in an aggressive move. Nearly spun out to 26. Wow! It's a miracle he even held that position. It's a miracle we didn't get a caution on that. That should have been a wreck right there. And that would have been a wrecked race car. Nice day by the 26. You know we need a good day. 28 times 2. DJ Curtis needs to win. He hasn't gotten a win yet. Happening. We do not want to see that 98 in victory lane. Considering they both have one win each. This would be detrimental to their chase hope. Despite DJ having a rough year, I don't think it would get him in the top 30 to be considered. But still, I'm sure they would like to prevent him from even having a win, knowing that he doesn't have anything to lose or anything really to gain. I mean, I shouldn't say he doesn't have anything to gain, but he does. I mean, he can't really do much with the win. As far as getting towards the chase. Now the 20's got to run. He's going to take the run. and take the lead. Or will he? I don't think so. DJ Curtis hangs on. For the time being, can he hang on? Will the 28 try to do a crossover? Keep in mind, DJ nearly wrecked the 26 a few laps ago to take the lead. You gotta imagine he may use the fact that he has to keep that 28 behind him. If I'm the 28, do I repay the favor on the 98 for your teammate? I mean, I wouldn't do it. Or maybe, actually, I would probably hit the 98, try to get him on the line. Considering this is a chance for a win, I would probably nudge him, get him a little loose, or get him on the line. I wouldn't wreck him for the win. I mean, you gotta win, but obviously it doesn't guarantee your chase hope right now. But knowing that you're so close on points, it'd be such a big gamble. And I'm thinking the 28 might have used up everything he's got. DJ Curtis is gonna get away. But, will they have to pit again? Because they don't have enough fuel. This could really open up a world of possibilities. Looks like they will. White flag is out, one lap to go for DJ Curtis. I mentioned the dog pile at the beginning of the race. This would be contributing to the dog pile if DJ Curtis wins today. But at the same time, this team needs a win. They've not had a great year. It would be a momentum booster for them, but for these guys behind them, it would be a dog pile effect that continues. And right now, Ace Rogers doing everything to run down this 98 car. He knows this is a chance for a win to get even closer to making the chase, if not clinch a chase spot. I gotta imagine if he can get to the bumper, he can force the issue. We've seen crazy finishes on this track. Can't count out another one possibly happening. Through the final corners, he's not gonna have enough time. There we go, he's gonna make the move, but too late. DJ Curtis wins at Canadian Tire. We add to the dog pile in a caution-free road course race. That's another astonishing number right there. Solomon Flores ahead. Looks like he might have gotten into a little bit of trouble in the closing stages. He has yet to finish the race. We have to wait on him. Get the official result. Now we have six to go. On the cup side, we're going to have four to go. After this race, we have five to go right now. It's going to be interesting entering these final races. or the chase. And we want to thank you for watching, and we will see you at Darlington. Till then, here are your results standing in Chase Grid. Goodbye, everyone.